If we don't do this, 2.2 million people die.
2.2 million people.
That was the prediction early in the pandemic. It came from experts at London's Imperial College.
The Imperial College model became enormously influential all around the world.
Science reporter Matt Ridley points out that the model led governments to act.
A statewide order for people to stay at home.
Everything we do is based scrupulously on the best scientific advice.
Politicians always say, I'm following the science.
There is no such thing as the science. There is science, and science consists of people disagreeing with each other.
The model did say that if all Americans practice social distancing, we could reduce the death toll to a million plus. But even without everyone distancing, our death toll has been much lower than that.
We've seen far too much reliance on models, which have very, very dodgy assumptions.
100% of the workforce must stay home.
Actually, what we did was quite dangerously wrong.
Because the model said COVID patients would overwhelm hospitals.
Patients were moved out of hospitals into care homes.
Where the virus killed the most people.
Go home and stay home.
The strict lockdowns may have done more harm than good. Norway's health chief now says a lockdown was not needed to tame COVID.
The main interventions that helped prevent people dying were things like stopping large gatherings, people washing their hands and wearing face masks, general social distancing, not forcing people to stay at home.
But governments did force people to stay home because the models misled them.
We all failed at that business, right? All the early national experts, here's my projection model, here's my projection model. They were all wrong.
But he and others should have known that the Imperial College researchers have a history of failure. Imperial predicted 136,000 deaths from mad cow disease, 65,000 from swine flu, 200 million from bird flu. The real numbers were in the hundreds.
Wrong again and again, and they just get believed the next time.
If you say something really pessimistic about how many people are going to die, the media want to believe you, the politicians daren't not believe you.
The world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change.
This bias toward pessimism applies to climate change too. Most of those predictions are based on models. Ever been to a Maldive island? 32 years ago, so-called experts said rising seas would completely cover the Maldives in the next 30 years. But it's been longer than that. The islands are thriving. They're even building new islands.
The Maldives are building several new airports. That does not suggest a country that is about to disappear beneath the waves. Climate change is real, is happening, but is not happening nearly as fast as models predicted, and we have time to sort out our economy.
Why do the models again and again, and the scientists behind them, overpredict disaster?
Predicting disaster is a very good way of attracting attention to your science and getting rewarded for it.
2020, we're out of oil.
We are at or near peak oil.
75% of our energy are simply running out.
The experts all said, we're about to run out of oil.
In fact, the opposite happened.
Ridley's new book explains how innovators repeatedly prove models wrong. In the case of oil and gas, higher prices inspired entrepreneurs to invent new ways of getting more gas out of the same rocks.
We were forecasting 10 years ago that gas prices would go up rapidly, less rapidly, or slowly. We did not have a forecast in which they went down, and yet that's actually what happened.
It turns out experts are wrong all the time. The head of the British Royal Society said heavier-than-air flying machines are impossible. In 1955, Variety said rock and roll music will be gone by June. Columnist Paul Krugman said the internet's impact on the economy will be no greater than the fax machines.
Experts do get things wrong, but they're more likely to be right than a layperson.
Tom Nichols wrote this book that says we should trust experts more. I asked him about the Maldives.
Everybody said they were going to be underwater by now. Everybody was wrong.
Expertise gets politicized. This happens in every field of expertise because we're human beings And we want our expert sources to reach the same conclusions that we want to reach.
We shouldn't dismiss the expertise of a doctor or an engineer when they're curing your disease or building your bridge. But we need to learn that there is no such thing as expertise on the future.
People tell me it's dangerous what people like you or I say, that people aren't going to obey the government's rules.
It's dangerous to rely too much on models that give you wrong answers and end up locking down society and destroying people's livelihoods. Danger lies both ways.
If you like these videos and would like us to make more, please help us do that. Press that button.